Hello to everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find the inverse Z transform of a signal in MATLAB. So first of all, you need to write certain commands: clc, clear all, close all. These are basically the commands to clear the command window. Now, in order to write a comment, you need to make use of modulus symbol. So before finding the inverse Z transform, we need to take one example and we will find the Z transform of that example. Here we are going to take an example of sine n. So we are going to find the Z transform of sine n. Then we will find the inverse Z transform of that signal to get this original sine function. So in this sine n, we need to define the n first, which is a symbol. So in order to define this n, we need to make use of sims command. So write sims n, and hence this way we have defined the symbol. Now the function is sine n, which we are going to plot. So f equal to sine n, and we are going to find the z trans of this function. For that we are having just z trans command in MATLAB. So write z equal to z trans f. Now if you want to display anything on the command window, for that you are having a disp command. So write disp inside that whatever you want to display. Here I want to display z transform. So after that write disp z and run the program and see the output on the command window. Here you can see the Z transform of sine n. Now we are going to find the inverse Z transform of this function. In order to find the inverse Z transform of this function, we are having a function iz trans. So we are going to make use of that iz trans function. So write iz trans. Inside that we need to write this Z function which we have obtained, and we're gonna store it in double Z for inverse Z transform. This is the way of finding the inverse Z transform. Now we are going to display a message on the command window displaying inverse Z transform. Now after that we are going to disp double Z. Go to run, click on run. After that go to command window and see the output on command window. Here you can see we get the original signal as sine n. Now after this we can take another example. Suppose the function is n instead of sine n. In that case, let's see the output, run it and see the output on command window. Here you can see Z transform is Z upon Z minus 1 whole square, and inverse Z transform of the signal is n. Thanks for watching.